Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Chemical Engineering Knowledge. In this lecture we will discuss some important topics of mass transfer, which is the pressure drop loading and loading. And fake bed column, PVC, fake bed column. So let's consider a fake bed column. Suppose this is a fake bed column. There is some packing material present in the fake bed column. These are the packing material. This packing material can be ration ring, it can be spoon, it can be saddle, or it can be plastic ring, it can be any type of packing material. The gas is coming from the bottom, it is coming out from the top. So gas is coming from the bottom, it is denoted by G. G is the mass flux of the gas, and the gas coming out from the top is the G out. G is nothing but it is the mass flux of the gas. Mass of the gas passing per unit area in 1 second. So what is the area, the cross sectional area? This area, gas which passed through this cross sectional area in 1 second. Now what will be the pressure drop? So as the gas passes through this packed bed column having the height h, then the pressure will drop. So here the pressure of the gas is p1, and here the pressure of the gas is p2. Now how the pressure changes in this packed bed column, inside this packed bed column? So as the gas passes through the packed bed column, the gas come in contact with the packing material. It come in contact with the packing material. So due to the drag force, due to skin friction, it is for friction, and due to form friction, which is due to the shape of this packing material, form friction. So as the gas passes through this packing material, due to the pressure, due to the drag force, skin friction and form friction, the pressure inside this column, the pressure of the gas inside the column will change, and it is called the pressure drop inside the packed bed column. And this pressure drop is nothing but it is the delta P. Now this column is called the dry packing, because this column is called the dry packing because there is no liquid water present in this column. Now in some cases, in most cases, like in absorption, we are using water to absorb gas from gaseous mixture to the liquid water. So we are using the liquid water. This is the liquid water having the mass flux is L, and this is the liquid in, and the liquid out. This is the liquid out. The unit of L is just like same. This is the mass of the liquid passing per unit area in 1 second. So the mass flux of the liquid is L, and this is the mass flux of the gas. Now this column become the irrigated column. Here this is the liquid and this is the gas. As gas pass through the column, some of the gas component will transfer to the liquid, and the liquid having gas will come out from the bottom of the column in absorption column, packed bed absorption column. Now what will be how the pressure drop and what will be the loading point? As we increase, for example, suppose this is another packed bed column. Suppose this is a packed bed column, and these are the some packing material present in. These are packing material present in the column. The gas flux come from the bottom, it come out from the top. This is G in, and this is the G out. As the gas flux increases, the pressure drop inside the column will increases. As we further increase the gas flux, the pressure drop inside this column will be further increases. As we further increase the gas mass flux, the pressure drop inside the column will further increase. Now, this is for the dry packed bed column. Now, in reality, we are using a column in which we are using some liquid to absorb gas from gaseous mixture. So, the liquid is coming downward and the gas is coming up in the column. Gas is transferring from gaseous mixture to the liquid water. So, absorption is occurring in this packed bed column and it is called the irrigated column. Now, in this case, as we increase the gas mass flux, the liquid will hold inside the column. The liquid will hold inside this free space, or the liquid will hold in this void fraction. So, if we further increase the gas mass flux, the more and more liquid will hold in this free space. Now, if we further increase the gas mass flux, large amount of liquid will hold inside this packing material. So, a time will reach when we further increase the gas mass flux, the whole column will become watery. So, the whole column or the whole free spaces or the whole void fraction will cover with the liquid. And after this, when we further increase the gas flux, the liquid will come out from the top of the column. And at this mass flux, and mass flux, suppose this is a particular mass flux. So, at this particular mass flux, at which the liquid is coming out from the top of the tower, is called the flooding point. And what is the loading point? The loading point is the gas mass flux at which only the liquid holds inside the packing material. So, the gas mass flux at which the liquid start holding inside the packing material, or the gas mass flux at which the liquid hold between the two packing material, or the gas mass flux at which the liquid start holding in the void fraction. So, this mass flux will then called the loading point. So, at loading point, the pressure is also high, but at the flooding point, the pressure is very maximum. Now we can draw this packed bed column with the help of a figure. So, suppose we have a figure. Suppose this is a figure. It is show us the logarithmic of gas mass flux, and this is the logarithmic of pressure drop. Now, this is for the dry faking. Suppose this is for the dry faking. Now, in this dry packing, when we increase the gas mass flux, the pressure drop inside the column increases. If we further increase the gas mass flux, the pressure drop inside the column further increases. So now, if we irrigate the column with some liquid, then we will obtain a curve like this. Now, if we further So, this is for the for dry faking, this is for the irrigated faking. These two are for the irrigated column. So, in this case, the liquid mass flux is increases. For dry, the liquid mass flux was, for dry faking, the liquid mass flux, which is L, was 0. For this is for the liquid mass flux L1. Suppose this is for L1. L1 is 2 kilogram, suppose 2 kilogram per square meter into second, and suppose this is for L2, which is 2 or 3 kilogram per square meter into second. Suppose this is L1 is 2 and this is 3. 2 kilogram per square meter into second, 3 kilogram per square meter into second. Similarly, for high liquid mass flux, this graph will obtain. For further high mass flux, we will obtain this type of graph. For further, we will obtain this type of graphs. So, this graph shows us as we increase the mass flux of gases, the pressure drop increases. Now, for the dry packing, as we increase the gas mass flux, the pressure drop in the column will increases. This from this figure. Now, for irrigated column, as we increase the gas mass flux, the pressure drop increases up to this point. Now, after this point, if we increase the gas mass flux, the pressure drop will sharply increases. If we further increase the gas mass flux, the pressure drop will further increases for this irrigated column. Now, this point is called the loading point. This is called the loading LP, loading point, and this point is called the flooding point. Similarly, at this flooding point, some author said that above the flooding point, some column can work and separation can occur above the flooding point, because above the flooding point, the column will act as a continuous column. So, this was for the liquid mass flux L1. Similarly, if we increase the liquid mass flux like this, we will obtain a curve like this one. Up to this, if we further increase the gas mass flux, further pressure drop will increase. If we further increase, further pressure drop will increase. So this is the loading point and this is the flooding point. This is for the liquid mass flux 3. Now, for liquid mass flux, suppose for liquid mass flux L1, which is 2 kilogram per square meter into second, suppose this one, if we increase the gas mass flux, pressure drop will increase. If we further increase, pressure drop will further increase. So this point is called the loading point, and this point is called the flooding point. So the loading point for L1 is this one. This is for L1. Loading point for L1, liquid mass flux L1, is given from this figure. This is the flooding point for the liquid mass flux L1. This is the loading point for liquid mass flux L2. And this is the flooding point for the liquid mass flux L2. This one, which is 3 kg per square meter into second. Now, or if we further increase the liquid mass flux, the pressure drop will further increase. So now, suppose at the same G value, the pressure drop for the dry packing column will be less as compared to the pressure drop of the irrigated column. Suppose at this particular G, the pressure drop for the irrigated, for the dry column will be this one. For the irrigated column having the liquid mass flux, which is L2, the pressure drop will be like this. If we increase the liquid flow rate further, which is 3 kg per square meter into second, the pressure drop will further increases. If we further increase, pressure drop will further increase. If we further increase, pressure drop will further increase. So, when we increase the liquid mass flux in the column, the pressure drop increases. So, similarly, when we increase the gas mass flux, if we increase the gas mass flux, the pressure drop also increases inside the column. This is because if we increase the liquid gas mass flux, the holding of liquid inside the column will occur, and the loading and flooding point will occur inside the column. Due to this loading and flooding point, the pressure drop inside the column will increase. So this is about the relation between gas mass flux and the pressure drop inside a packed paired column. So we should decrease. Now, how to avoid the flooding and loading point? So if we keep this gas mass flux to some optimum value, so we will avoid the flooding and loading inside the packed bed column. So actually, we should keep the G gas mass flux low to avoid the loading and flooding 1. So the optimum gas mass flux can be kept 0.5 times the flooding gas mass flux, or it depends on the experimental condition. Sometimes the optimum gas mass flux is equal to 0.8 times the flooding gas mass flux. So it depends on the experimental condition, the temperature, pressure, and the viscosity of fluid, which are gas and liquid inside the packed bed column. So these gas mass flux and liquid mass flux depend on the temperature, pressure, and other experimental condition of the packed bed column. So this was all about the packed bed column. Thank you very much.